Okay, see what we did, session.remove session user. We have removed it. There are some other options. The session dot, there is next one method which we have to use, remove all. For example, I created on the login page, I used a single variable session user. Single session I have created. The key name was user's name. So my the entire application, you will have a number of session variables. Number of. So once you log out through the application, please mute it, guys. Bala or Tushar. So if you in the entire application, might be the developer has created number of session variables because they wanted to transfer it from here to there. So what they can do, once you log out, you have a facility called remove all. It means it will remove all keys. I have created one key, session user. So remove all method will remove all the keys values from the session state. So I can use all these things. You have to use like this. The third option for session dot, there is method called abandon. Abandon means whatever the current session which you have created, if you wanted to remove that one only, you can use abandon. 99.9% people are using these two methods simultaneously. Session dot abandon on the logout part. People are using session.abandon means cancel the current session, means log out. Remove all, whatever the session objects you have created, remove all. Just one, remember one thing, session will be stored at server side as well as on the client side, both the side. So if you remove all, means the session gets discarded or removed from the server itself. Okay, so make a habit, whenever you are doing for some logging out and all those things, use abandon. If you want to remove, because somebody has created huge number of session objects, so if you want to remove a specific object, then you can use a session.remove. Based on that, you can write a code. The best approach is I can make it as null. That would also fine for me. You have set it as null, that means that's okay, you have removed the session. But practically, the ASP.NET is telling us, instead of setting a null, you can use an abandon or remove all. Abandon for the current session, current variable which you have created. For removing all session variables, variable values, go with that removal. This is the way of doing. Now, the next option is, if you check, clicking onto the logout, admin 123. Onto the login, it came here. Now placing a breakpoint here, see what is happening. Logout. It is breakpoint. Abandon means session is being removed. Remove all session is being removed. Null. Okay. If it is null, then it should navigate to the login page. Press F10. Oh, not null. Okay. It is setting as empty because I have created a variable as an empty. String type variable. I have not set it as what we call the nullable type of variable. Okay, see what I did, string.empty. That is why. If I made as null, that would also okay. Okay, so I can check, it depends how we are writing a code. I can check something like this. Okay, string.empty. I can do this. I can check with the null as well. If I click on logout, if the person has created login, it navigated. I'm copying this URL. If somebody is trying to access it from outside or unauthorized person without logging, press enter. This is my home page. But why it came here? It should not came here. It should go to navigate to a different page, error.aspx. Remember? Let's run it once again. Because I have set it null, string.empty. Okay. It's not equal to string.empty. Click on login. It came here. Now I copy this URL. Stop it. Okay. Stop this one. This is the login page. Or what we can do. Or first we can do. Just set this start page because I wanted to debug it. Okay. Just making as it is start page for this page. Let's run it. I'm not going for a login. It is coming to dashboard directly. Press F10. See this value is available or not. It is empty. If it is empty, then it should go to the redirect page, error.aspx. The same way. I wanted to debug it. That's why I make that one also. See where it is going. You are not authorized user. If somebody says that without login, so we have to return it in a different way. Now, re-login it, I have to create a link to so that user can go to the login page. Going to the error.aspx, there are a number of options. I'm just using a simple one. Anchor tab for hyperlink. A, href. Hyper reference anchor tag for linking up pages equals to, I can mention the page name. What was the page name? Login.aspx. Okay. Then you have to write like this. Let's run it and see. Dashboard, it is coming to, because session is not available because I have not logged in it. Re-login. It became a link button type of thing. On the bottom side, if you are able to see my screen, on the bottom side, type here to search. To above that, you will see localhost 50 here itself. You can see here, okay, on the bottom side. You will see it is navigating to login.aspx. I clicked it here. I came back. Where I can use a log admin, then I can put 1, 2, 3. Then now I am able to see the page. But session variable value is being created now. Okay, it displayed. To click on logout, it will again go to the login page. Any doubt, any confusion for writing the code, or any confusion which is
no, sir.
Tushar.
No, sir. So 1 minute. User session. Okay, in that case. User session or session dot user null karne ka is, in case mein kuch fayda nahi hai null ka.
Nahin.
Yeah.
See, if you want to really check the null, okay. So what I can do, I can just make it as null. Okay. Instead of checking, where I was checking this empty, I can check null. Okay. It depends what type of data I have stored it. I captured as string.empty, that's why it was the default value. Okay.
Yes.
The way of doing it. Got it?
नो नो माय क्वेश्चन इज कि ये लाइन नहीं लिखते थे यूजर डॉट सेशन डॉट नल, तो एबिटेंट किया तो ऑटोमेटिकली वो नल हो जाता है क्या?
ओके I have created a property where I'm manually setting as. Okay, the best option is you have to abandon or remove all. Okay, but there is a other option if you are doing a programming, then you can set as null manually. Don't rely on ASP.NET. Okay. Now, the next part. I'll repeat everything in one application once we did all the state management. Okay, just focus everything right now, because that time I'll do some go for little fast, okay, while pulling the data and everything. Okay, let's do with the okay, let's go with the, some database right away. Okay, go with the new application. ASP.NET empty website I am using. Click OK. Remember, we did something in the Windows application. We created some database connections in a class.
Yes, sir.
So we'll go with that thing. Data access layer. Remember, we did it. Can I use this class? Just control. We'll do with the three-layer architecture. Okay, but we'll go little later because Akshay should also be in a class. Now, I'm just putting a data name I have given. What I'm doing, see, just copying and pasting. I already pasted. I'll do right click data set, right click resolve. That's true. Employee classes is still missing. This is a one time investment only, right? Going to the employee class, go to the and let me add these two classes. Okay. Add one more class here. Add new item. I'm just making the file name as that's it, nothing. And here I'm just replacing the code. Same class and everything is same now. Everything is same. I'm not going to change anything right now. Now, for the database connection string, I have to specify something. The header itself, I can write a query string in the web config file, or we can avoid it for now. Okay, no way. Double quotes, I can write hard coded thing. Data source equals to, I put my server name, it's a local, semicolon, initial catalog where you can specify your database name. Database name was HRMS, I think so. Semicolon integrated security equals to true. There is no requirement for username and the password. I put it here. Okay, records and everything is same now. Let me confirm with the SQL Server whether I have which data.
HRM is something.
Yes. Yeah, HRM is. Okay. I have to write a method for login check. Okay, here itself. Public bool. I'm just specifying it. I'm just giving a method as login check for now. Here I can pass string, or can I do one more thing? You guys tell me. Can I create an entity here itself? User login. Can I put it something like this, where I can specify two properties, public string, username, public string, I can make it as password, and just removing these two things. I can use a user login class, passing it here. Login. Have to write a code to validate the data from the database itself. So what I can do? Okay, we did for disconnected mode. Okay, no issue. We'll go with the disconnected, no issue. Okay. Do with the connected mode as well. So here I am, what I am writing, ADPT equal to select star from whatever the table name we have, user login. So I'm just writing user login. This is the table name. Okay. I have not started with procedures and all those things. We'll do later. Select start from login, where username equals to @ username and password equals to @ password. We did in the last time. Adding the parameters, what I have did on the last session, select command dot, I can make this variable, copy this variable, paste it here, and here you can write user login, whatever the property you have created, username, control C. I know it is little bit tough for you for now, but once you make the habit on this one time, two time, repeat multiple times, then you can remember the entire thing. Whatever the table name I have, I can give it here, user login. Okay. Now I can check. If, and what I'm seeing, doing.
If obj dot
tables, square bracket, whatever the table name you have given on the top, user login, because data set is a collection of table. I'm just checking one table, DST obj dot tables dot rows dot count is greater than zero. Means what happened here? If this query runs successful, I'll get the data from the database, right? Then I'm checking, did I get any row here? If yes, I can return. I can put this bool, something bool result. Okay, equals to, I can make it as default should be false. You can make null, no worry. Result equals to, I can return true. I mentioned it. Else, if there is no record, I can put result equals to false. Or even though it's not required to return false, because I already set it as result equals to false. Okay, now let's return result. That's okay. Now, Now, what I am going to do, I'm going to create one page, right click, add new item, web form, login page. I did it. I'm going to create a table here itself, okay, by using some add insert table. I put at 3 rows, 2 columns. Just giving username. The text box I have to specify it here itself. Text box. Here I am writing password. Just box here itself. Box. Now here I can put the checkbox. Button. Instead of going with the button first, right click, okay, insert, I can row below, okay, I'm just writing here itself in the button. Why I have left this, we'll do later. Now, giving a BTN login, I'm repeating everything whatever we did till now related to a session, okay, and the ADO.NET itself. TXT user name. This would be TXT password. TXT password. Text would be login. Now I'm adding one more page here. This is the login page. Once you logged in, then it should navigate to some home page. I'm just giving a web form name as home. Home.aspx. Okay, this is the home page. I'm logging it. What I am doing, see, data access layer, DAL OBJ, or see the writing way of creating an object. You can write the first letter should be small, then leave it as it is. Equals to new data access layer. Data access layer dot, I can put login check, what it is expecting user login. So what I'm going to do, I'm creating an object of user login. See how I am doing it. The first letter should be small. That's it. Equals to new user login dot the username. Equals to, can I put txt username.txt? See, I am not writing any code here for login check. I am just passing some parameters to a different class. Txt password dot text semicolon. Now I can pass it here user login. That's true. R. I am just checking is login success. Let's do that. Why I have written is login? See, place a cursor on the login check, it is returning bool. So I can make it as bool, anything, or where is the dynamic keyword. Let's do that. I'm going to run this login page first. Okay, I have not checked whether the properties name are in the user lay, username and the user password. Let me put some data inside the table. Admin 123. Okay, running it. I'm putting value is admin. The password is 123. I think so. What's it? Admin 123. Click on login. Coming to what happens, see initial catalog. My word is not I key is I. Click on login. Value segment is 123. Login. It is coming here. Press F11. It is going inside that, okay, Okay. There is an error. Password spelling. What is the keyword here? User password means I have given something wrong. Username. This should be. Let's read. On to the login. In. 2, 3. Click on login. It's coming here. Press F11, F10, 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 and see in the DST OBJ. Data set is a collection of tables. The first table has given a name as user login. I got a record. So what I am checking, if I got a record, rows.count is greater than 0. I got a record, correct? So it will navigate me or it will return me true. Go there and see what is the is login success value. It's true. It means if is login success, by default it would be true. We'll check as true. Then it should navigate me, redirect their home page, home.in. Okay. Else, if it is not successful, I have to return a message. Username and the credentials are invalid. Before going to that, you have to apply some required field validators and everything. What I am doing, I am just placing a label here for printing the error message. Don't use response.write. Response.write always write on the top of the screen. So what I am doing, just using a label here itself, or you can place in the bottom side. Okay, there's no problem with that. I'm just giving a message LBL error. Okay, you can just remove it, the text as well. Add, but you can remove. In the login check, I can mention as LBL error dot text equals to login credentials or whatever the message you want to pass, or invalid credentials, something. You can give a message like this. Just paste it 1, 2, 3. If successful, then it will navigate. Now the ones. Got it? We can do it with the database right now. Next, once you successful logged in, I need to pass the data from one page to another page. Okay? So what I did, I have to use a session. Correct? For the session purpose, I have to create a class for now. I'm going right click, add new did that class session variable key. I have to write it again. Okay.
Session manager.
Yes. I'm just copying the class. That's it. Add a class. Website, add new item. Class. Yes. Time it always become. Okay, session management, same. What I'm doing, session management, the variable I have, class is created. What I am doing, just see. If the user is success, login credentials are success. So what I am writing, session management, session OBJ, or you can write like this. See what. Copy, create an object similar to that. The first letter should be small. Equals to session management dot session user equals to, I can put txt username dot text. Okay, I'll get this value there on the other page as well in the home.aspx. I'll get it. Write it here, sir. Okay. I can print it, or I can place a label here itself. So I'm just printing the phone dot write. That's it. That would be fine. Or here I can check if this particular variable, if I can write a code like this also, not string dot is null or empty. If it is null or if it is not null or empty, print it. Did I make something? I can return to a different page, whatever the page we have created, response dot redirect. I can put it as error dot aspx. I can put like this, whatever we did in the previous class, our previous project, same thing I did. I'm able to specify with the database also. Now you guys tell me, is it a good way of doing like this? Because see, I'm just passing a text box name. I'll tell you first. First one thing. Okay, click on login. I'm getting the value admin, whatever I did. Now you guys, what you need to do, for example, I am just checking the username and the password. But in the database itself, you will have some other fields. The first name, the last name, correct? If you go, might be there is one more field, email ID. Got it? If I'm opening a Gmail account, let's understand two things, then we'll go. The server ID. Is my email ID. Somebody wants to see the my password, what he will do? Press F12. Go here and select this and change this. Where it was the password. See, enter your password. Enabled. Don't see. Okay, click on next. Now this is the big drawback I have seen in Google Chrome right now, without changing anything. For example, let's do with some other thing which is not showing. Let's go to the Facebook first. For example, see, clicking onto the logout, I have a logout button, I can change it. See, the name is showing me Ashwin. This yes. Name I have not entered in the credentials, right? What I did, Ashwin.Kumar01.
Yes, yes.
Is getting it. What I am doing right now, see, it is showing me Ashwin and the profile, correct? The profile picture. Here, there should be some email ID column, first name, last name column. There should be some other columns as well. So what I'm doing, as per the requirement, if you want to specify something, if you want to pass that particular first name and last name or the email ID to a different page, I can use the section. This particular part, what it does, it is just only for checking the username and the password, nothing else. Correct. Can I write? Can I pass a username and the password? The first name I'm just checking login check, or I can write a method find user. Okay. Or I can write user login. Create a login this object instead of only checking the username and the password. I'm checking everything. See, find user, right click, generate method. That's it. Okay. Go to the here, go to definition here. I came here. What I need to check? I'm writing the entire code once again. Control C, Control V. I wrote it. Data set, everything is correct. Here, instead of using the result, I'm creating an object user login. Control C, paste user login equals to new user login. Okay. If I got the data from the database, so I can put a property, user name equals to, I can write to what I can write. See, remember we did a code for this one. Username equals to rows of zero dot, then column name I have to specify the username. I can return it like this.
Okay.
I can return it, right? Username or what? Here, nothing else. Return user login. That would work for me. In scope, where I have created it. Okay. This one. My mistake. Okay. From the next class, you get the login response. Instead of I'm returning the username, can you return the email ID from the database? If there is a email ID column, there are some other columns. First name, last name, I can return it, right? I can create one property. For example, I'm just reading a value, user ID. See, user ID, I can return it. I'm just capturing username, you can use anything. Here I'm checking on the login page. User login response I'm writing. Okay. If user login response is not equal to null, if it is not null, then it will navigate to the different page. And here, whatever the data you are getting from the database itself, you can write it. Let's see. In 1, 2, 3, click on login. It is going inside that F10. I got the data. See in the user login response, username 1. You can create one more property, email ID, and fetch the email ID from the database itself. So in the Facebook, in their table, they have username and the password, along with they have the email ID. So on the credential side, on the username and the password login screen, you are entering email ID and the password, and they are fetching the data, the name, the first name from the database and capturing into the session variable. I captured the username. The username I got one actually. Okay. They can pull some username. See one I am printing. So in the same way, go with the Facebook, what I am doing, I entered the entered email ID. I'm not entering anything. Email ID and the phone number. So once you add these things, it will validate the data and pulling the other column value. The column value first name, we got the Ashwin. Got it?